name is Marina, and welcome to Fall in the Field 2020, Nature's Tales, Stories of Change and Resilience. We are here at Hyatt Lake today, and we're going to be investigating our own story of change by mapping the watershed here at Hyatt Lake and also analyzing the water storage graphs of Hyatt Lake. So let's get started. We're going to take a little hike down this trail to another part of the lake. Here we go. Let me tell you how this lake, Hyatt Lake, was created. It was created in 1923, so that's almost 100 years ago, and with the creation of this dam. So this dam blocks the water that would normally flow down Keen Creek, and it holds it in this reservoir here. So what is a reservoir, you may be wondering? A reservoir is a body of water that is either natural or human-made that is used for water storage supply. This water here in this lake would normally flow down into the Klamath watershed, and instead it goes through the dam, which we'll see in a minute, down King Creek, and then flows into a human-made canal that flows underneath Highway 66, which is the road that I drove here on, and down into Immigrant Lake, which is in Ashland. Maybe you've been there with your family. And then after that, it flows through a canal in Ashland and Talent and eventually gets to the Rogue River. So what is this water used for anyways? This lake is owned by the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation and is owned and operated by the Talent Irrigation District. So this water is irrigation water for farms in the Rogue Valley that grow food that you eat. And then in times of drought, this water is also treated and then used for drinking water for humans as well too. Hydrologists today, or water scientists, and thinking back to the questions that you posed in the beginning in your T-chart, what you wanted to know about Hyatt Lake, we're going to be investigating our own stories of change and resilience today. So we're going to be thinking about this question: how does the water in a watershed affect people downstream? So let's break that question down into some smaller parts. First of all, what is a watershed? It's not a shed where you hold your water. It is actually an area of land where water drains down into a low point, like a lake or a river or the ocean, some kind of body of water. And another word for a watershed is a catchment or a drainage basin, and so we're going to be studying that today. I have a really good way of remembering what a watershed is, so I want you to practice with me. I'm going to do it first, and then I'll have you follow along after. So this involves hand motions and words. So a watershed is an area of land where water drains down into a low point. So you're going to practice it with me. You can stand up if you want. So a watershed is an area of land that drains down into a low point. We are always in a watershed, no matter where we are on Earth. So next, what you're going to do is click on the YouTube video link to watch a little video about watersheds.